I'm a human. This, ladies and gents, is Cooper. Hello, mate. Say hello to YouTube. This is the man behind the camera's dog and my wonderful training partner, Kate. Yes, Minnie. Mm-hmm.
Right, get the whiteboard.
I'm saying the high rock session I did on Wednesday, which you'll have seen on the YouTube previously, I believe last week, if these all work correctly. Honestly, I'm in a fucking bin, like, hips.
Good morning!
God, bloody. And this motherfucker. Tell YouTube what you did.
Wait.
Now.
Wait.
What'd you get, mate?
Group.
Oh, you motherfucker.
Sorry, guys.
After Ali's call yesterday, I'm happy with his goal.
Good call that yesterday, you should try and watch it again.
Did he record it?
He will have, aye. There was a post the other day from JP. And it basically, the general consensus is that the smarter you get, the harder it is to make decisions, because your brain just starts thinking, oh, I need this, isn't it? And you need to remember who you're training, and also what the people need from the session.
Yeah.
And basically, JP's post, he writes how he speaks, and it's meant to, like, lands on me anyway.
Yeah.
And he was just saying, like, there's a time and a place for, like, line of force, paths, certain ranges and
movement
stuff.
Movement arms and all that.
Movement arms and that, but at the end of the day, unless you look like someone who already trains, you just need to fucking lift weights and find intensity. I'll do 3 6 9.
I'm staring.
My day. All 10.
Yes, team, we are back, and today is Super Saturday X Cycling Saturday. So, what is this day all about? So, Cycle Saturday, Super Saturday is probably the pinnacle of the week. It's a great way to round off a solid week's training. For me, Saturdays are all about community. It's about pulling everyone together. It's almost like a match day. So like coming from the football background, and a lot of guys in here have been in sport all their life as well. And they miss that kind of like competitiveness that a match day kind of brings. So for me, Saturday, Cycle Saturday, so to speak, is it's like a match day. You pull your socks up, you get locked in, you dig deep for your teammates. It's normally in teams of 4 to 6. So even if you are struggling, it doesn't matter what ability you are, you've got your mate to dig you out of the shit and help you out. And yeah, it's fucking some experience, some energy, and we're going to capture it on camera, no doubt. As hard as it is to pull an atmosphere through a camera, because I do feel like you've got to just be in it to understand, we'll absolutely try our best. And Super Saturday for me is just a nice time to go off plan with some of the boys. It's normally mainly Marcus. It's a chance for me to program a little bit, and like I say, come off program and just go old school bodybuilding and just do what we love basically. So I'll double tap today. We'll do 6 a.m. session, which I've done with a like an upper body sort of push pull session. That's our Super Saturday. Refuel, rest, and then we go again for a 9:30 kickoff with the boys. So we're about 15 minutes out from Cycle Saturday kickoff. There's 30 people booked onto this session, which is absolute maximum capacity. There's a few of the coaches jumping in on it as well, which I think raises the pressure, raises the expectation. I'm gonna go and ask a couple of our members now why they constantly come to Cycle Saturday, why it's their favorite day of the week. It'd be nice to hear a little bit of an insight, I guess. Come with me. Simon, how are you doing?
Good.
Simon, we're currently filming for YouTube, all right? And today we have 30 people in booked into Cycle Saturday, and you've been doing them the last three, well, I know you've done 3 weeks in a row now because I've been alongside you dying on the gym floor. First and foremost, how old are you, Simon?
51.
Sorry, say that again?
51.
51.
How long have you been coming to training club?
Oh, they're doing getting psyched at somebody.
8 months now.
8 months, cool. And why is Saturday, like, why do you come every week? Why do you love it?
It's just a brilliant team atmosphere.
Yeah?
It's great.
What would you say to somebody who, because of their age, like, limits their belief to think that they can come and attend Cycle Saturday?
Oh, I was like that when I first started. I thought, I'm not going to be able to cope with this, but you get used to it.
Yeah.
You get dragged along by the atmosphere, you know?
So, the biggest thing I think on the Cycle Saturday, like, when I introduced the video is, you're in teams of 4 to 6, so the community, the team drags you through. No matter what your ability is, you've got your mate to the left or the right of you who will absolutely get you through that session if it is a big one, which today will be. But yeah, thank you for that. Come on. Simon, everybody. Who else have we got? I'm here with Scotty Bell. As of today, he has actually been with us 1 year. Is that correct?
Yes.
He's had his 1 year anniversary.
I'm running this.
And basically, mate, what I'm doing is I'm kind of asking people why on earth they love Cycle Saturday, basically. Why is Saturday their favourite day of the week? Why do you keep coming and putting yourself in a ditch every Saturday?
Tell the people.
Mate, I wish I knew the answer.
That's, no
it's like game days, mate, you know what I mean? Like, been just playing football for that long. Saturday, it's a team environment. Everyone gets buried, and then everyone stays back at the end of the day. Everyone does it for the same reason, I suppose.
Would you say, like, well, basically, I actually introduced the video by saying that it's like a match day for us who've played football and stuff or competed in sport. Do you feel like that you miss the football side of things now? You've got this kind of facility and this kind of thing on a Saturday?
No, honestly, that's something I've said since I joined, really. I was like, I was always going to stop playing on a Saturday, and then this came along, started playing on a Saturday, and
all right.
I get the same buzz, but then I've got the whole day to myself. I still get that match day fix.
Thank you, bro. Thanks for that, mate. Top man. Huh? You look nervous as well, mate. You're nervous to coach. You're on my team today. Big performance. Get that in you. The boys are talking tactics.
It's all going on today.
Mr. Ryan Burton.
We're fucking back here.
TC athlete.
It's been a minute since I've been here.
It is. Ryan's just qualified for Athex Finals, so he'll be representing us
in Athex in London, I believe, or Birmingham in December.
Birmingham,
Manchester. He's also, tell YouTube what you do with your sport as well.
Race motorbikes, basically, like endurance.
At what level?
British level, yeah.
So he's he competes at British level. In what is it again? What's a class as?
It's like British Enduro.
British,
yeah.
Enduro. So he's an absolute fitness ninja. And when Ryan Burton's in the room, you know it's going to be a tasty session. If you're on his team, you best pull your socks up because you'll be getting showered at and lashed. So yeah, as you can see, he's getting his pre-match coffee in, which only means one thing: it's going to be tasty. Thanks, bro. Here he is. I've been looking for him. Anyway, Harry. One of our longest-serving members.
Yeah.
How would you explain and describe Saturdays at the training club?
It's different. I think it's competitive. It's different to the other sessions. Everything like kind of comes together and competes against one another. So I think that's the best side of it for me. Yeah. Saturday.
The competitive spirit.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Alright, so essentially it's a chipper workout, so you're starting from top to bottom and you've got to complete it as quick as you can, okay? We've got Whisker, Matty, Scotty, Zach, Cycle Saturday debut for you, mate. First and last, Simon Forrester and Chris Lorraine. Alright, boys, so just where we are, can we spread out? Give us 10 press-ups, 10 body-weighted squats and 10 calories on any cardio piece. Spread out. Get through two rounds of that for us boys, we'll regroup, and then we'll go through the run. I'll see. No, it's a mess.
Okay?
Yeah. I was gonna see.
Everyone else outside?
Yeah.
Right, boys, listen in. So they're gonna do the 1K route. Whilst they do that, I'd like everybody in the room to run a unit 31 and back. Alright, so we're there. As soon as I'm outside getting them underway, everybody inside is going unit 31, come back and then get in your pods, okay? Start about 30 metres from the roundabout and back. Yeah? Unit 31 boys, you know where we are? Okay, boys, we're gonna go in. 3, 2, 1, let's go boys! 1K run, off we go!
Fitz Riggs here, oh yeah.
Samantha first, come in! Come on! 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 Come on!
Guys, that's a wrap on episode 5 or 6 of this YouTube Ground Zero series, depending on when this gets posted, that is. So we showcased Super Saturdays, myself, Marcus, sent it this morning with Kate. We have then showcased Psycho Saturday and what Saturdays are all about. It's absolutely a fan favourite here amongst the members. It's also my personal favourite. And the best thing about it for me is that we get to throw it down on the gym floor, be competitive, dig deep for each other, and then come out and bond and connect. In the coffee club, which is exactly what the whole place was about, I guess. So as you can see behind me now, the guys are enjoying the post-workout breakfast paninis, the oat bowls, the shakes and whatnot, refueling. And yeah, it's just a sick vibe overall. I think you have to truly experience it to understand it, but I guess that's why it's such a unique and special place. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, give us a follow, let us know what you want to see more of, and I guess I'll see you at the next one.